Uda, this new breed of Japanese players who are a lot less passive than the likes of Mitsutani and Kokiniwa, as brilliant as they were, and it's now route one all-out attack. Clips the net there again. First time we're seeing Lin Win ruin singles here on table one, and the fans, the young fans especially, will be really, really happy to see him. As well as Uda, but more so Lin Win Ru, I feel.
2-1. I actually wanted to see whether Lin Ju Yu uses his own wood or the wood of Zhang Zai.
1-3.
Zhang Jike, man. The modernizer of the backhand flick, the inventor of the reverse pendulum serve. Two-time world champion, one-time Olympic gold medalist in singles.
2-3.
What a brand of man which I don't think can be replicated in table tennis again.
Lin Win Ru has beaten him twice.
Wow. Wow, 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 wow. After a long time, Fraser, someone from Chinese Taipei is coming so high in table tennis.
I mean, we've seen Chuang Qiyuan. Let's Chuan not Chua, overlook yeah. Chuang Qiyuan.
Chuang Qiyuan or Cheng Peng Lung was there, one of the big players.
But Chuang Qiyuan never really had the full penetration to be able to beat Ma Long or Fan Jendong.
Never, never.
Lin Win Ru has in some ways.
Yeah, he has.
I agree
he
with that.
Definitely has.
Springy and very explosive play. Working on his game physically, Lin Win Ru, because he's always been quite lanky. Uda is definitely the more, which is stocky.
I feel if this Lin Ju Yu puts on some muscles, he would be the most feared player on the circuit in times to come.
Wow, okay. So you feel he has the mechanics to be a world number one?
Yeah, yeah, definitely he has it. Definitely he has it.
Playing like that now, the silent assassin.
As I told you, a little bit muscles on these shoulders and arms and legs, and wow, he would be an explosion.
2-7.
Versatile is the adjective I would use to describe Lin Win Ru. That is perfect. He thought he was going to be short, so he was getting the bat over the table for the touch, adjusted to play the loop, and then corner to corner. Wide serve. Wow, that's impeccable play from Uda. Alongside Tagami. In the combination the world of table tennis knows as Udami, they are the world number one. Udu is world number one in men's doubles.
Wow. Means in a way, tsunami in table, doubles table tennis.
3-9.
Causing a wave, that's for sure. But look at this, Lin Win Ru picks his opponents apart.
You're already 9 points up.
Nine.
He really has an explosive return, you can see, Fraser. The backhand flick is so strong.
Lin Win Ru?
Yeah,
yes. Lin Win Ru. The best, in my opinion.
The best.
I think a lot of people would agree that Lin Win Ru has the best flick. Chiquita, banana. Doesn't play the strawberry, like a lot of the Japanese women do, especially.
Yeah.
But traditionally brilliant. And there we wrap things up. A gift. We hope they'll be there at the smash.
Yeah. At least the entries seem to be there on the monitor.
1-1.
Lin Win Ru's wrist is so flexible and he can come around the ball in such a nature that sometimes his flick doesn't actually have a lot of topspin on it. It has so much side spin that when you try and block it, it goes in the bottom of the net.
And it goes to the other side.
Look at the power as well. We used to think of him as a spinner, but now he's got the power on top of that.
That is what I was telling you. If he put on little bit muscle in his arms and legs, he will be an explosion on table tennis. Explosion.
The way he reads it, man.
See?
So good.
He kills it. He really kills it.
Old head on young shoulders, Lin Win Ru.
Before you blink an eye, his shot has crossed you.
No way. Oh, he tried to go down the line, you cheeky chap. That would have been similar, actually, to a point that Bolt won against Lin Winroo at the Champions in Macau last season. Going down the line there against the momentum of the opponent. He tried it. He's so confident, brimming with it now, Lin Winroo, and grinning with the lead. Well, they call him a silent assassin. He does chow, but quietly.
Assassin is an apt word for Lin Junyu. Really, I will not agree to that sound assassin, but assassin would be a right word because assassin is associated with the guy who really does his work really professionally.
Yeah. And he does kill his opponents.
Yeah, I see the Japanese, the thought process in their mind is, what are we supposed to do to stop this guy?
Yeah, they know his class. He's loved and feared, really. Sometimes you don't know how to feel about Lin Winroo as a player. Togami, Kizukuri, and Shinazuka up there.
2-5.
Uda and Tomokazu Harimoto.
Who do you think, apart from Harimoto, would be the best after Harimoto?
Who's next best?
Next best after Harimoto.
Togami or Shinazuka, I feel.
6-2.
Do you still feel they can challenge the Chinese now?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Definitely. I mean, Shinazuka's taken Lin Chidong to 7 last season at the Summer Series. Harimoto beat Lin Chidong at the Contenders of Grab there. Close. Close with each other right now, and I feel as though the Chinese men's coaches haven't had this level of concern in some time, and they've also got Soro Matsushima coming up.
What about these two lions who are there on the top, the three lions who are standing on the top? Who comes close to beating these three lions?
You mean Fan Zhendong, Ma Long, Wang Shuqin?
Yeah. No one else. No one else.
Harimoto, really, is the only one.
That is, in that context, I'm asking you, who would be the guys who would really beat these three lions? Because their hunger doesn't seem to stop at all. They're getting more hungrier day by day.
Uda, to be fair, at the last Singapore smash, took Fan Zhendong to 6 games. Physical Japanese with the serve. Uda! You've scuppered it. Stopping his own momentum there.
Yeah.
Shame for him.
Gifting the point to him. Gifting. Criminal mistake.
Tickling the ball before he serves Lin Winroo. And a nice adjustment on his tippy toes to get over that loopy high ball from Uda, which was deep, to be fair. How he was on the back foot and with that ripping counter got on the front foot in a split second will put fear in players even when they're attacking against him.
Did you see those two backhands?
How could I not?
Wow.
How could I not?
Wow.
Whoa, catches the edge.
6-9.
Then Winroo now playing in Europe in the leagues.
Yeah?
With Tomokazu Harimoto, Charles Morgard, and Dmitry Ovtcharov in the same team, Sunil.
Which club?
TTC Neu-Ulm is the club, and it's 4 game points.
Wow. With Harimoto, Ovtcharov, and Lin Junyu, wow, it's an unbeatable combination.
And, of course, the Swede. But it's the silent assassin, 2 in the lead. He's flown the nest, shall we say?
Yeah.
1-1.
Coach Iseki for Lin Winroo.
We also had some time back Harimoto's father in the back. Now he's also not to be seen.
Nope, you Harimoto.
Love too.
Sometimes, I'm not saying this happened with them at all, but sometimes the parent can pressure the player too much and the player needs to have some independence of thought, especially in a match.
Not sometimes, Fraser. It is 9 out of 10.
Mm.
9 out of 10 times.
In the match, that is. In the match. In the training hall, it's different.
Even if the parent is standing behind you, it puts a pressure on you if you know the parent is watching.
Maybe you, Haramoto, knew that, and that's why he's not there all the time. Still sometimes for Miwa. She's only 14. What? Haramoto now is 19. Tomokazu Haramoto, that is.
He's already now 6-7 years on the circuit, I think, Haramoto.
This is the thing. Then win, wow.
No words can describe it. I think words are insufficient to describe this talent. Really, words are insufficient.
Look at the side spin on that.
Yeah, yeah.
Bent the wrist to guide it out of reach. Stunning.
He was there. He was there.
He never looks rushed, Lim Winroo, does he?
He has that extra second to play, I think. He's got that extra second to play. Gets that extra second.
He's never beaten Xu Xin, who is now going through an ambiguous patch, shall we say. But he's beaten Ma Long and Fan Zhendong. Xu Xin has never lost to Haramoto and or Lim Winroo.
Three.
Xu Xin is like Malin, I think. Both are in their own league.
Against non-Chinese, Xu Xin is actually, when you look at it, the best out of the lot of them.
You cannot imagine the balls he gets back on the table. How many balls he gets back on the table, which are unbelievable that they are lost, actually. You see, they are already lost, but that ball comes back.
When I say he's the best out of the lot of them, I mean against non-Chinese. Xu Xin is the most undefeated in that category.
Good.
Uda bringing in that heat. Hard-hitting Japanese player.
But when we make statistics, Fraser, we always consider their performance against non-Chinese, I think.
Well, this is the thing. You can guarantee a Chinese winner, it sometimes doesn't matter too much if you lose to a Chinese, fellow Chinese in a big tournament, and that happened with Xu Xin. Apart from at the 2019 World Championships where he lost to Gozi.
Yeah, he lost to Gozi. And did he play the latest Chinese qualification for the World Championships?
He didn't,
In China?
No.
No. But is he injured or something and he stopped playing?
He's a father. He's creating a brand called Superman, which is a cafe, table tennis cafe.
Oh.
Got a few other things going on. I'm not sure whether we're going to see him here again, competing at this level. I hope we do, but I don't know what's going on, so I'm not going to say too much.
Okay. Really, TT will miss him. That's for sure.
The Cloud Walker.
Yeah. That much we can definitely say, that we will definitely miss him.
But back to this. At the second towel break, 6-6.
And the assassin is on the job.
He's headhunting, isn't he?
Yeah, really. And with a cool head on his head, shoulders.
There's the flick.
That's the comeback. That's the Djokovic return.
We've heard the bat on the table, but we can't see it yet. But is Uda called the timeout there?
Timeout!
Yes.
Yeah.
It's the other times it's been a whitewash for Lin.
A very, really bad legacy or a bad record to carry.
In your head. Lin Winroo seems to be very confident against the likes of Lin Shidong and Zhang Peng. I know he's beaten Haramoto in the T2, but it would be interesting to see him face Haramoto here, for example.
That would be a really explosive match.
Angles! Goodness me. Look at that.
Would it be a dream final in Star Contender, Fraser? Lin Junyu and Haramoto together?
Well, they're on the opposite sides of the draw.
Wow, there is a chance, Vince.
6-10.
4 match points coming up.
Great save there. Working against the side spin, opening up the racket and going down the line. Lovely from Uda. He will fight till his last breath, but it's still 3 match points for Lin Winroo. Another
two match point save.
Already used his timeout, Lynn, in that second game, where Uda began to creep back to 5-6. And now it's 10-8. Tickling the ball and coming in now with his pendulum. It's the Silent Assassin. Change of placement, and he's done it. The cunning, clever clogs, Lin Win Roo, the Silent Assassin, not a chore to be heard.